My name is Pearl. I'm in my 60s, and I'm an advocate for the rights of LGBTQI plus Christians. I'm the oldest, and I have two younger sisters. My name is Pearl, and the other one is Ruby, and the other one is Jade. We were born and grew up in Hong Kong. So as a child, we remember that, well, we have a lot of happy memories together, even though I bullied them, okay? They followed me everywhere. And we have fond memories because my parents and I, when we were young, we lived with our grandparents. It's always been a lot of gatherings, a lot of families, a lot of delicious meals. And so it was a lot of fun in Hong Kong growing up. And my youngest sister, her name is Jade. She was a veterinarian and a great surfer. She lived, she lived and worked in Florida, but sadly, she passed away about a year and a half ago of lung cancer stage 4. So growing up as a bisexual is kind of natural. But I, of course, back in my days, you know, when I was a teen or growing up, we didn't have these terms. So I don't know that, I didn't know that I'm a bisexual. I only know that, you know, it comes very natural to me that I'm attracted to both sex. So that's what I remember distinctly childhood. I will always remember when I was forced to come out to my church, and that was a very homophobic church. And they all said that I'm a sinner and I have to, you know, I have to leave my partner. But I just couldn't do it. Then one Sunday, I walked into a church, and that is an affirming church. And the moment I heard that, you know, the pastor, the reverend said that this is an affirming church and everyone is welcome, I just broke down and cried. That was a pivotal moment that actually changed my life. The most memorable one is when I came out to the whole divinity school with 9 other queer students. So you know how the setting, you know, it's a Christian setting, and we have a lot of course, conservative, you know, students. And we chose to come out in the chapel. So that's very sacred, you know, to us, to everyone, it's very sacred. And the 10 of us just stood up and say our name and declare our sexualities and just tell them that, look, this is, you know, this is a community, we are family, but, you know, we are among you. So that's our purpose. So I think that is the moment that I treasured most. That's the reason I'm doing what I'm doing now. My life's work now is to do with queer theology in the hope of helping and affirming, you know, people from the margins and LGBTQI plus people. How to make the world a better place? This has always been my question for the past 9 or 10 years, okay? Of course we know. What is utopia? What is a better life? That means when everyone is really equal, okay? We see each other as human beings. That is a better world. What advice would I give to someone in their early 20s? I listen from them. I listen to them. I don't give advice because we learn. Actually, I think that we learn from each other. So I don't want to give advice. I like them to listen to my story and I listen to their story. And from our stories, we learn something. We grow together, yeah.
And what advice would you give a young Christian person who's struggling with their sexuality?
Leave the church. No, seriously. Can you repeat the question? Get help.